Hi all, today we are going to discuss about intersheath grading of cables. So before going to the intersheath grading, let us see what is the need for the grading, what is intersheath grading, and then we will proceed further. So I am assuming I am taking a conductor, let us assume it is having a radius of R, and without any type of grading, let us assume a single insulating material is used and the outer side there is a sheath, and this insulating material is having a permittivity of, let us assume, epsilon, and it is having a radius of some, let us assume, take it as R1. So the permittivity is epsilon. So let us assume the potential at the surface of the conductor, let us assume this is equal to V1, and the potential at the second side or at the sheath is equal to some V2. That V2 can be 0 or any non-zero value also. So now if you want to calculate the electric field intensity at any point, if you want to find at any point at a distance of x from the center of the conductor, and this x is greater than the radius of the conductor, can be given by Ex is equal to, let us assume Q is the charge per unit length, Q divided by 2 pi into epsilon multiplied by x. This is the value. So now the maximum value of electric field intensity will be at the surface of the conductor, because inside the conductor the electric field intensity will be equal to 0, because whenever a conductor is exposed to electric field, inside all the charge carriers will come on the surface. If you want to know about the details of this, you can refer to my EMFT lectures where a conductor kept in an electric field. So what will happen? So there I have discussed this. So I am assuming that you already have idea about that with respect to the distance x and how the electric field is changing. Electric field will be maximum here and it will go on decaying as you are going away. Okay, now this will be my value of E maximum, and here this will be E minimum value. So now this maximum value of the electric field intensity or the potential gradient, so this I can write as Q divided by 2 pi epsilon into, it happens at the surface of the conductor, so I am taking it as R. Let us take it as equation number 1. So now the potential difference I can calculate by, because potential difference will be V1 minus V2, that is the difference between these two points, will be minus integration from, you are moving from the outer side to the inner side, that means we are moving from R1 to R, this will be Ex dx. So this will be equal to minus integration from R1 to R, Ex is equal to Q divided by 2 pi epsilon x into dx. So this one, if you do the integration, this will become equal to Q by 2 pi epsilon into ln of R1 divided by R. This is what we get. This is the value of V1 minus V2. This is the value of V1 minus V2. So now this I can write, that E maximum I can write in terms of the voltage, because V1 minus V2 is equal to Q by 2 pi epsilon into ln of R1 by R, or otherwise Q by 2 pi epsilon, whatever is here in the E max, that can be replaced by V1 minus V2 by ln of this one. So from equation number 2, I can modify the equation number 1. The maximum value, E maximum value will be equal to, this will be V1 minus V2 divided by R into ln of R1 divided by R. So this is the equation we got. So you can see here, by varying the value of the potential difference between the two points, I can easily control what is the maximum value of the gradient that is coming. So we know that whenever the cable is designed, there will be a parameter called as the dielectric strength. So dielectric strength is the how much value of the voltage per centimeter it can withstand. Now this electric field intensity is also the same. It is the potential per unit length, because the denominator, you can see, because ln will become normalized, so R by R it will become no value. So this is voltage by the distance, or this I can write as kV per centimeter. This is nothing but the dielectric strength of the material. That means, let us assume the dielectric strength of the material is equal to G. G is the dielectric strength of the material. So the dielectric strength of the material should be equal to whatever is the maximum, that is gradient that is coming, multiplied by the factor of safety. This factor of safety will be used, because in future, the with respect to the time, the dielectric strength of the material will goes on decreasing, because it absorbs the moisture. And second one, in between, due to the switching transients or other things, there may be voltage surges may come, even at that instant also your dielectric should withstand. So that's why the factor of safety is taken. So let us neglect the factor of safety now. I am taking as 1 for the case of theoretical calculations now. So we can tell that this material should be designed to withstand for this maximum value of the potential gradient. If maximum value of potential gradient can be decreased, so automatically we can go for a material having lower value of dielectric strength. Or for a given dielectric strength, we can tell that V1 minus V2 that will be equal to E maximum into R into ln of R1 by R. So as the E maximum is more, so automatically V1 minus V2 will be more. The difference of the potential, or the given cable can be used for higher voltages for a given size, or for a given voltage the size can be decreased. Or that I can explain here, like V1 minus V2 is fixed, E maximum we know that is the material property, because if the material is having the more value of the potential gradient, so then automatically the radius that can be used, or the radius of the conductor will decrease. Or otherwise, same thing is the case, this R1 can be decreased because ln of R1 divided by R for a given size of the conductor. So we can tell that either the size of the conductor or the size of the cable can be decreased for a given type of material if V1 minus V2 can be decreased. So this is what we are going to prove in the case of intersheath grading. So I am just trying to summarize what is happening in the intersheath grading. Without intersheath grading, if you apply the potential, you can see here the maximum gradient is only on the surface of the conductor. As you are going away, the potential gradient is going on decreasing. So material is designed to withstand for this E max, but here at this point E max is very less, because the electric field is less. At this point it is much more less, but we are using the same material. That means you are underutilizing your material. I want to increase the utilization of my material in a proper way, or proper utilization of my dielectric material, such that the size of the cable can be decreased, or the same size cable can be used for higher voltages. So let us try to see how this can be done. So now going for the intersheath grading. So in intersheath grading, let us assume the radius of my conductor I am taking as R. So above this I am taking a material, let us assume the first material. So the material will be same used here, all the material will be same. In between there will be metal sheaths are used, and they are maintained at different voltages, so that the potential difference concept will come there. So this is R, so let us take it as R1. So similarly here some intersheath is kept, again one more layer of the same insulating material is used, so epsilon is equal to same. So this value I am taking as R2. Again one intersheath is used here, and then above that again insulation is kept. Let us take this radius as R2, material is same. So now these are my metal sheaths. Metal sheath, and this is my conductor. So what will be done here? Here we take one transformer, and let us take this as zero potential, so this is at zero. So this potential will be connected to this first intersheath, and another potential will be maintained at another intersheath, and the conductor will be maintained at a potential of V. Let us take it as V, V2, V1 and 0. These are the potentials that are connected. Here V is greater than, V2 is greater than, V1 is greater than 0. And the second one that is maintained for maintaining this one is, so I am taking the ratio of the thickness of the conductor, or the radius from the center of the conductor is maintained, the ratio is maintained same. That means R1 divided by R is equal to R2 divided by R1 is equal to the outer radius, that is R2 here, R2 divided by R1, this will be equal to some value alpha. Getting this? So now the gradient at the surface of the conductor, that I can write as V minus V2 divided by R into ln of R1 divided by R, because I have told you that how to derive this. This is V minus V, difference of the potential, divided by the inner radius, ln of outer radius by inner radius. So I have written the same thing, R into ln of R1 by R. Similarly, gradient at a distance of R1, gradient at a distance of R1, because second material is starting there, or one intersheath is there, the potential is changed now. So after the first one, the potential is V2, and the next potential is V1. So the difference becomes V2 minus V1 now. So there I can calculate my electric field intensity or the gradient. Both are one and the same, please don't confuse. So this I can write as E max or G max. So again at this point, at the radius R1, this will be equal to the potential is V2 minus V1 divided by, what is the inner radius? Inner radius is R1, ln of outer radius by inner radius. This is R2 divided by R1. So similar is the case, I can define at the radius R2, that will be equal to V1 minus 0, because the potential is here, that is V1, and here it is 0. So V1 minus 0 or V1 divided by, what is the radius there? The radius is R2, ln of that radius is R3 divided by R2 or capital R divided by R2. Different books mention in the different way. Please change this. This is equal to R3. See, this is R3 divided by R2. So please change it. This is R3 divided by R2. Please, I make a small confusion there. So R3 divided by R2. This is what we get. So since the value of the maximum potential gradient, because material is having the same gradient, or dielectric strength of the material is same because same type of material is used, so I want that at every sheath the maximum gradient is same so that the material will be properly utilized. So I want that E maximum is same at all radii. That is my target. So then I can tell that all these values will be same. That means V minus V2 divided by R into ln of R1 divided by R. This will be equal to V2 minus V1 divided by R1 into ln of R2 by R1. This will be equal to V1 divided by R2 into ln of R3 divided by R2, or capital R divided by R2, whatever you take. So now we know that this R1 by R is equal to R2 by R1 is equal to R3 by R2 is equal to alpha. So this becomes ln of alpha. Same thing is the case. This becomes ln of alpha. This also becomes ln of alpha. So all these things will cancel because we are equating them. So we can tell from this V1 minus V2 divided by R is equal to V2 minus V1 divided by R1 is equal to V1 divided by R2. So let us take it as equation number 1. So I want to compare this with the material without any type of sheath. If the sheath is not applied, only one potential will be there because outside potential will be 0 and on the surface of the conductor potential will be V, and R will be the radius of the conductor. And some, let us define in terms of alpha so that the ratio we can get easily, outer radius by inner radius in terms of alpha. So first what we will do, we will express V1 in terms of V2, and then we will express V2 in terms of V, so that I can easily calculate what is my maximum potential gradient. So what I am doing, I am taking from this equation. So this equation, from this equation, I can write that V2 minus V1 divided by R1 is equal to V1 divided by R2. So I am equating the first term and the last term. So what is the equation number? So let me write the equation number so that confusion will not be there. So the equation number 3 is over. So I am keeping this as equation number 4. So we can tell that from equation number 4, I am writing this one, V1 divided by R2. Or from this, I can write my value of V2 is equal to R1 multiplied by V1 into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. I am taking V1 to the second side. Or this I can write as V1 multiplied by 1 plus 1 by alpha. If you calculate, you will get this, because we know the ratio of R2 by R1 is equal to alpha. So that's why I have substituted this one. Or from this I can write V1 is equal to V2 into alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. Let us take it as equation number 5. So similarly, again from equation number 4, I am taking the remaining two equations, that is V minus V2 divided by R is equal to V2 minus V1 divided by R1. Or from this I can write V minus V2 is equal to V2 minus V1 divided by alpha. Or this I can write as V2 by alpha minus 1 by alpha times of, we know V1 in terms of V2. So this will become equal to V2 into alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. So this I can simplify. This will become V2 by alpha minus, this will be V2, this alpha alpha will cancel, V2 by 1 plus alpha. So from this I can calculate my value of V. So this V2 will come to the second side. So I can write as V2 multiplied by 1 plus 1 by alpha plus 1 by 1 plus alpha. So this I can write as V2 multiplied by alpha into 1 plus alpha, first term, plus 1 plus alpha, that is the second term, plus third term will be alpha. So I think when you take this one to the second side, this will become minus, right? So this will become minus. So please write it as minus, that mistake I have done. So this will be alpha divided by alpha into 1 plus alpha. This is what we get. So now this I can write as V2 into alpha plus alpha square plus 1, because alpha into alpha is alpha square. Then alpha into multiplied by 1 is equal to alpha. Here 1 plus alpha minus alpha, minus alpha plus alpha will cancel out. So 1 will be there, divided by alpha into 1 plus alpha. This is what we get. So this will be V2 will be equal to V1. So denominator will become numerator. So this will become alpha into 1 plus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha square. You got this value of V2. So let us take this as equation number, because previous equation we have taken as equation number 5. So this will be equation number 6. So now from this I can calculate my value of maximum gradient in this case. So the G max is equal to, which is nothing but equal to E maximum value. This will be V minus V2 divided by R into ln of alpha. So this I can write as V minus V into alpha plus alpha square divided by 1 plus alpha square divided by R into ln of alpha. Or this I can write as V by R into ln of alpha into 1 divided by 1 plus alpha square. So this is the value of E maximum with the case of intersheath grading. So let us take what will be the value of the gradient without any type of intersheath grading. That means either I am having one conductor and there is a radius. So this radius is equal to R3 and this inside radius is equal to R. So in that case, how it is going to come? So now in that case, I can calculate my, let us take it as E maximum dash. So this will be equal to V. V is the potential difference between these two. V divided by inner radius into ln of outer radius by inner radius. This is what we get. So this I can write as V divided by R into ln of, what is R3 by R? Because R3 by R, from that equation, we can write this R3 by R as R3 by R2 multiplied by, this I can write as R3 by R2 multiplied by R2 by R1 multiplied by R1 by R. This is same only. This is alpha multiplied by alpha multiplied by alpha. It will become alpha cube. So that 3 will come out in the ln. So this will become V divided by 3 into R into ln of alpha. So this is the second equation we got. This is without intersheath grading. So now let us take the ratio of the value with the intersheath grading divided by maximum value without intersheath grading. So if you take the division of these two equations, VV is same, R into ln of alpha is equal to same. So the remaining terms will come. You will get this value as 3 divided by 1 plus alpha square. Or we can tell that the gradient, or this is the maximum gradient with intersheath, is equal to 3 divided by 1 plus alpha square times of the maximum gradient without intersheath. I am writing on a glass screen here, handwriting doesn't come properly. So I am providing the complete handwritten material in the description of this video. You can please download the material from there. Here you try to understand the concept what I am teaching, because everything I cannot represent properly in the material. So I am teaching it here. So now we know that the value of alpha, which is the ratio of R2 by R1 or R1 by R or R3 divided by R2, because this is always greater than 1. So we can tell that whatever this maximum gradient with intersheath, it will be 3 divided by 1 plus greater than 1 plus greater than 1 square. It will be greater than 3 always. So we can tell that because of this, the maximum value with intersheath is less than the maximum value gradient without intersheath. Or we can tell using the intersheath, the maximum gradient is decreased. Or this means that the cable of a particular size can be operated for the higher voltages, or for a particular voltage, the size of the cable can be decreased. So the voltage rating of this cable I can write as E maximum into R into ln of R1 divided by R plus R1 into ln of R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into ln of R divided by R2. I am just taking the potentials, all the three potentials I am adding. Or this I can write as E maximum into ln of alpha, because ln of alpha is same here also, here also, here also. This will be multiplied by R plus R1 plus R2. This is my total value of the voltage for which the cable can withstand. That means for a given value of the gradient, the cable can be used for the higher potential if the dimensions are same, or if you are maintaining the E maximum and the voltage constant. So automatically, because you are getting it as ln of alpha multiplied by R plus R1 plus R2, the size of the cable will be decreased by going for intersheath grading when compared to normal value of the grading. Because without intersheath grading, the potential will be equal to E maximum into the inner radius into ln of alpha. Only this one will come. This will be alpha cube. So this will become equal to 3R into ln of alpha. So here this is greater than 3, that means we are getting the greater value. So automatically, in order to compensate that, we can decrease the value of R, R1 and R2. Or if the radius of the conductor is fixed, at least we can decrease the value of R1 and R2. So automatically size of the cable get decreased. But practically the intersheath grading is not used due to the following reasons. The first one is the possibility of damage of intersheath during the laying operation. This is the first reason. Whenever the cable is being laid, there is a chance that it may get damaged, and that creates the local points where the gradient will increase, and that may lead to damage of the equipment. That is the first one. And the second reason is because you are providing the intersheath grading, so because of that the charging current that is passing, or the capacitance, because the capacitance will be more in this type of cable, so automatically the charging current will be more. So this charging current depends on the length of the cable. As the charging current is increasing, so automatically the heat that is produced will increase. As the heat is increased, there is a chance that your cable may damaged because of this. So this is the second reason why intersheath grading is not used. So in the last class we have discussed about the capacitance grading. There I forget to tell the disadvantages of the capacitive grading, or why the capacitive grading is also not used. So that I am going to summarize here. So in the case of capacitive grading, so first one is the non availability of varying permittivities. That means we want different materials having different values of the permittivity. We calculate the permittivity using the formula. So same value of the permittivity material having same potential gradient, because we have assumed that the G max is equal to same, that is practically very difficult to get it. And the second one, this permittivity or the relative permittivity of the material, this changes with respect to the time, because it absorbs the moisture, so automatically the relative permittivity of the material will go on changing. So when this material relative permittivity goes on decreasing, when the relative permittivity decreases, the automatically the potential gradient, so that potential gradient at any point will increase, and this may lead to rupture of your cable even for the working voltages. Because permittivity is not fixed. When the permittivity is not fixed, whatever formula we calculate, that will not work practically, because with respect to time it will go on degrading, and finally your cable may damage due to the overheating or because of the crossing the limit. So it will be rupture, because E maximum value or the dielectric strength of the material limit will cross, because dielectric strength will goes on decreasing and the cable may damage. So practically the grading is not used. Whatever we have studied is only theoretical. Practically grading is not used in practice because of these limitations. I hope that complete grading of the cables, why the grading is not used, what are the theoretical advantages of the grading are clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.